All right, good evening, dear teachers. We are going to start with a song again tonight. All right, you know I like music very much. And tonight we are going to start with another classical song. It is a Cyndi Lauper song. Last week we had a Gloria Gaynor song, a classical disco song, which is one of the famous, the most famous songs of all times. Tonight, we have another song which is also popular. Can you see the screen? I want you to tell me if you see the screen, please. You can type in the chat bar or you just can speak. Feel free to speak, to participate. Can you listen to me? Can you see the screen?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, yes.
All right, good. Okay, let's just start then right away. Okay, with tonight's song, which is, as I told you, a classical English song. Tonight, our focus will be on the three language systems. And we are having the first part of this talk, of this lecture tonight. We are going to continue talking about the three systems in our next webinar. So tonight, the focus is on the three language systems. And it is a great chance to increase our knowledge of the three systems of the language, as well as discuss the challenges students face at learning the language when reading, when listening, when speaking, and writing. All right, let's start with the song then. I hope you like it. I'm going to play the guitar again. Right. Can you hear my guitar?
Yes, yes, yes.
Let's start you, teacher.
Okay, good.
One, two, three. Four, five.
All
right. Home in the morning light, my mother says, when you gonna live your life right? Oh, what are we? We're not the fortunate ones, and girls, they wanna have fun. Oh, girls, just wanna have fun. Rings in the middle of the night, my father, just what you gonna do with your life? Oh, daddy dear, you know you're still number one. The girls, they wanna come back. Oh, girls, they want to come. That's all they really want. Some fun. When the world in the is done, oh, girls, they wanna come back. Oh, girls, they wanna come back. Wanna come back, girls, wanna come.
All right, let's go with the second part now.
Some boys take a beautiful girl and die, girl, away from the rest of
life.
We
want
to be the one.
We want to be born in the sun. Oh, girls, they wanna have fun. Oh, girls, wanna have
fun.
Oh, girls, they wanna have fun.
Bravo. Great, great, fantastic.
It's a nice version, right? Because the singer is a woman, actually. So it is cool to have a voice version of this song. I hope you enjoyed it.
Yes.
All right, let's start then with the content of tonight's presentation. I told you that tonight we will be talking about the three language systems, all right? I want to welcome you all again for being here tonight to share these teaching experiences together and increase our knowledge of effective methodologies, strategies, and techniques for teaching English successfully. We are going to start then right away with our riddles, with the way we have been doing this every week, every time we've met here at the webinar. We have five riddles again tonight, and here is the first. All right, I want you to give me your answers, all right? The first riddle says, where can you find cities, towns, shops, and streets, but no people?
In a map.
Excellent, excellent. In a map, that's the answer. In a map. Ooh, point for the girls. So girls wanna have fun tonight, right? In a map. All right. The second riddle goes like this. What has a face and two hands, but no arms or legs? What's that? What has a face and two hands, but no arms or legs? Five.
A sun.
A photo. No, not the sun, not a photo. Karen is saying a photo. It gives you the time. I'm giving you a clue. It gives you the time.
A clock.
Yes, a clock. A clock, that's the answer. A clock has a face and two hands, but no arms or legs, right? All right, next. What goes up but never comes back down?
Bills.
Goes up, but never, what did you say?
Bills.
The bills, the bills. Yes, also. What goes up but never comes back down?
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening, Lucila.
How are you right today?
Ah, yeah, could be.
All teacher right. Lu says what did you say? What would be the answer?
Teacher Luz Roque said DH.
DH, yes, Luz, you're right. Yes, Luz, point for you. Another point for the girls.
Oh,
it comes back down. Yes, our age. Yes, Luz. Excellent. All right. Next. What is able to travel around the globe, but stays in a corner the whole time?
The rope?
What?
The rope? No.
The rope. A rope.
No.
No. So what is able to travel around the globe, but it stays in a corner the whole time? No? You see this on letters?
Mm-hmm.
You send a letter, mm-hmm. You put this.
Signature? Stamp. Claudia says stamp.
Yes. Stamp. Yes, Luz. You were right again.
Claudia too. Claudia Condor too.
Okay, good. Oh yes, Claudia and Luz. All right. A stamp. All right. Okay, this one has to do with the post too. So what begins and finishes with an E, but only has one letter?
A
It's a tricky one.
Begins
with an E and finishes with an E, but only one letter.
An E.
It's a good one. This has to do with the post too.
I
know. No.
Yeah.
It
envelope. An envelope.
Claudia, yes, 1 point for you.
Ah, yes.
Yes, Claudia. Envelope. Yes. An envelope.
An envelope.
Envelope starts with E, finishes with E, and has one letter. One letter.
Ah, yeah, that's right.
Ah, tricky one.
I am again, Claudia.
Claudia, yes. All right, very you well done.
You can rest, Claudia, you can rest.
All right. All right, okay, good. Let's move then to the first part of tonight's presentation, which is an overview of what we will see, not only tonight, but also in our next webinar. The first two webinars were related to ELT effective methods. Now, tonight's webinar and the next webinar will have to do with the three language systems. So we will have two sessions to cover this topic. Right now, I want to tell you who these webinars are for. So who are these two webinars for? Tonight's webinar, the coming webinar. All right, Claudia, don't worry. Don't worry, but you can type. I'm reading. I'm always trying to read all your comments. And thanks for telling us about the call you're suffering right now. That's okay, Claudia. All right, who are these webinars for then? If you are interested in learning how to teach grammar, how to teach vocabulary, how to teach pronunciation successfully, and applying this to your classes, then this webinar is for you. All right? Also, if you want to have a look at some English language teaching games and ideas for both face-to-face and online classes, then this webinar is for you. It's for you too. All right? However, if you want a totally theoretical exposition of the three language systems, then this webinar isn't for you. All right? I want this webinar to be very practical, and I want you all to interact with me throughout the presentation so that we all have a chance to contribute. It means to learn and to share together. All right? What will we talk about today? What will we talk about tonight? First, we are going to talk about what people mean when they talk about language. All right? Then we are going to focus on how to teach grammar, vocabulary, and pronunciation. This is our job. This is what we do, right? Also, we will cover some challenges that the students have with grammar, vocabulary, and pronunciation. Remember that all these things will be covered tonight in the next webinar. Also, we are going to focus on some English language teaching games and ideas for our classes tonight, next time. And we are going to learn or revise, share together, as usual, some ELT terminology, since this is important for us as teachers, because we need to be familiar with teaching terminology, because we are the specialists, we are the teachers. So I want you all to be familiar with teaching terminology, and I hope that by the end of the program, you know more terminology than now. I am sure this is going to contribute positively in your teaching. And once again, if after finishing the program, you feel ready to take a teaching exam, like Cambridge TKT or Cambridge TKT-YL, that's fantastic. All right? So good. Let's continue then. The first thing we will cover then tonight is what people mean when they talk about language. Now, in the chat bar, I want you all to participate. I want you to write a definition of language. What is language for you? What is language? What can you associate language to? or for you in your own words or in two or three words, what is language for you? I want you all to participate, to type in the chat bar. Good. Claudia, thank you. Language, communication. Please, I want you all to say something. Write a definition of language in the chat bar. You can also turn on your microphone and speak. Say something if you want. All right, so you can type your answer or you can speak in front of everyone and tell me what language is for you. Okay, Edgar, it is the way that one can communicate with others, all right? Julie, a way to communicate, a way to interact, a way of interacting. Sylvia, good, thank you. Okay, Carlos.
Thank you.
System of communication, you're welcome. Robert, language is a communication system, all right? Zoila, system of communication. Interact with other people. Madeleine, good. All right, anything else? A way of interaction, Sylvia, thank you.
Yes.
All right, interact through communication, Karim. All right, good. Yes, what else? What else is language for you? I'm sure you all can contribute and say something. Christina, it is a new culture, all right. A means of communication, Elisa. All right, good. Good, that's fantastic. All right, you're doing a great job. Right, what else? The different forms, the different ways that a person can communicate with others. Edgar, thank you, good. It is a method, Zoila. Okay, even using signs or mimics, yes, this is also language, right? Mm-hmm. Right, yes, you don't necessarily use words to communicate. Lucila, it is used for a particular country, all right? Ways of communication, Marisabel, Robert, language is what we use in order to communicate something. All right, good. Now I want you to see my definition. Everything you said is right. This is contributing to our webinar and to build up learning tonight related to the three systems of the language in ELT. I want you to see my definition. Once again, it is not that my definition is right and yours is wrong, but this is more or less what language should be associated to, all right? Thank you, Catherine, communicating and writing, speaking with other people, using different situations. All right, so language, okay, is a system, yes, as you said. We often talk of language as a system. It is not an abstract code, but a system that enables, a system that permits, a system that allows, a system that lets us to communicate meaning. And we need to master, we need to dominate, we need to be good at this system in order to be able to use the language effectively for communication. Especially us. Why? Because we are the teachers. So we have to be good at both our language and the language we teach. All right? So we are the teachers. We have to be good at our own language and we have to be good at the language we teach. What language do we teach? Who can answer this? What language do we all teach? Why are you here? Because you are
English.
English. This means English. That we have to be good at English. Are you good at English grammar? If your answer is so,
yes.
Sometimes it depends. This means you have to work on this because you are the teacher. So if you feel you are not very good at grammar, you have to take action because you are the teacher and you have to be good at grammar because you are teaching a language. Are you good at vocabulary? Are you good at pronunciation? if your answer is so-so, I don't know, sometimes you have to take action. And tonight we have a great chance to revise these three systems, grammar, vocabulary, and pronunciation, and improve not only the way we can teach grammar, vocabulary, and pronunciation, but tonight I think we will also have a chance to improve our own grammar, our own vocabulary, our own pronunciation. All right, so that's fantastic. Tonight, I'm sure we are going to learn a lot together. What are the three systems of the language then we will be covering tonight? I have been mentioning this all the time since we started. What are the three language systems?
Grammar, vocabulary, and pronunciation.
Are you familiar with these words? Do you teach this?
Yes, that's why.
Yes.
Do you have to teach this? Yes, right?
Yes.
All right, we all are familiar with this because we all are supposed to cover this in our classes. We are supposed to teach grammar, to teach vocabulary, and to teach pronunciation. All right? So we are going to start with the first system I have prepared in my presentation for everyone tonight. What is grammar? Okay, the definitions we will see, the concepts we will share right now have been taken from the TKT course book, which is a Cambridge preparation course book for English teachers that are planning to take a teaching exam, Cambridge TKT. So from the book, I want you all to see, to know tonight that grammar refers to the way we combine, to the way we organize, and the way we change parts of words and groups of words to make meaning. We use grammar all the time, unconsciously. When we speak, we use grammar unconsciously. Also, when we listen, we use grammar. When we read and when we write, we use grammar. We use grammar all the time. And we use grammar, particularly as teachers, to describe language. Because sometimes you know that your class, your lesson is connected to one specific grammar point, like, this week or this month, I have to cover present simple, present continuous, adverbs of frequency. So we particularly as teachers use grammar to describe language. We do this by referring to its forms and its uses. And grammar includes a large number of forms and uses. This is what we will see tonight. What are grammatical forms? What are these uses we give to grammar? Grammatical forms refer to how words are made up and presented in a speech or writing. In speaking or writing. For example, the form of the plural of regular nouns in English is base word plus s, like chair, chairs, table, tables, like boy, boys, door, doors, right? But there are some exceptions and we should know this. We should know the things because we are the teachers. So in English, we have regular plurals, those which can be formed by just adding the letter S to the word, like chair, chairs, door, doors, table, tables. But there also exist irregular plurals in English. Like, for example, who can tell me?
Teeth, woman, women, men, man.
Child, children.
Women, child, children, mouse, mice. Fish, fish. The plural of fish is fish, right? Not fishes. So it's the same, fish, fish. Man, men, woman, women, yes, deer, all right?
Deer too.
We, the teachers of a language, should know the things very well because we are the teachers. If you don't know grammar very well, once again, you have to take action right now. Another example of how we can refer grammatical forms are nouns. There are common nouns and proper nouns. in all languages.
Mm-hmm.
An example of a proper noun is a noun like a country, the name of a place, names of people are examples of proper nouns, like Maria, yes, Edgar. Like Maria is an example of a proper noun because it is a name. Right? Delcy, very good. Tuesday is another example of a proper noun. Days of the week, nationalities are proper, are considered to be proper nouns in English. Are they proper nouns in Spanish? Days of the week are proper nouns in Spanish?
Or
they
no, are not teacher.
No, common. They are common. Yes.
They are common.
They are common. And you write common nouns with small letters or capital letters?
Common.
Small letters.
Small letters, yes. You write common nouns in small letters. So if you write Wednesday or Friday in Spanish, you have to write it in small letters, not in capital.
Yes. Okay.
You have to do
in English,
it in capitals.
English with capital letters.
Yes. Right? Okay, thanks for participating, Delcy, excellent. Common nouns, small letters. Julie, thank you. Robert, thanks for participating, Madeleine. All right, so the form of the gerund, for example, which is ing, is something that is referring a grammatical form. And we have to be familiar with all these things. What I am mentioning right now, has to do with basic grammatical forms. What would be some basic grammatical forms? Present simple, adverbs of frequency, singular and plural, present continuous. But if I say third conditional, is this a basic grammatical form? You teach the third conditional in beginners one or beginners two?
No.
No.
So there are some grammatical forms. There are some grammatical forms that are more complex, that are more complicated, that are more difficult, right? And they are part of our teaching because we have to teach these things, not at the beginning, but we have to teach the, to teach this, all right? Elisa, thanks for your advice. I've already turned off all the microphones. Please, dear trainees, I want you all to keep this in mind. In case you want to participate, you can open your sound. You can turn on your microphone. And don't forget to turn it off when you finish your intervention. All right? So it is off for everyone right now. All right? But this doesn't mean that you cannot speak. I want you all to interact with me and to participate. But in case you want to have an intervention, please turn your microphone on, then you finish, turn it off. All right, good. So we can identify grammatical forms in parts of a speech, grammatical structures and words that contain prefixes, like a group of letters added at the beginning of a base word, and suffixes, a group of letters added at the end of a base word. There are 9 parts of a speech in English, and we will cover this tonight. I have uploaded material that is related to this in the platform. I've seen that many of you are completing the platform very quickly. Also, I see that most of you are enjoying your learning in the platform. The information we will see tonight is connected to some of the information you have posted in the platform, in the Teachable and Abilities and Education platform, in which you are advancing your program, this course. Right now we are going to see what the 9 parts of a speech in English are. This is nouns, verbs, adjectives, adverbs, determiners, prepositions, pronouns, conjunctions, and exclamations. Have you seen this in the platform? If yes, please say yes or type in the chat bar. Have you already revised this information in the platform in your course? I want you please to say yes, Claudia, yes, all right. Delcy, yes. All right. I see that many of you, thank you, Ceci Salcedo. Carlos, good. All right, Giovanna, good. I see many of you are enjoying your learning at the platform. And congratulations, I want you to keep up the good work. All right, I am sure you are learning a lot. Yes, you say yes, yes, good. That's fantastic. That's fantastic. That really motivates me, to give my, to do my best all the time. So a part of a speech or word class describes how words behave in sentences. For example, how they operate and combine grammatically with other words. Now, what is lexis? Lexis is what we call vocabulary, right? So the three systems we are covering tonight are grammar, vocabulary, and pronunciation. So right now we are going to focus on vocabulary, which is also called lexis. What is lexis then? Lexis refers to individual words or sets of words. For example, tree, get up, first of all, all's well that ends well. This is units of vocabulary which have a specific meaning. What kind of meaning then can words have? Well, we often speak of the meaning of words, right? In fact, words have different kinds of meaning. Firstly, there is a meaning that describes the thing or idea behind the vocabulary item. For example, if I say tree, you know that a tree is a large plant with a wooden trunk, branches, and leaves. This meaning is called the notation, like the concept, what everybody knows. And if you look for the meaning of the word tree in a dictionary, probably you will find this, a large plant with a wooden trunk, branches, and leaves. This is called the notation. This meaning is called the notation. And we speak of denotative meaning. But there is also another type of meaning, which is called figurative meaning. For example, we say the tree of life or a family tree. So this imaginative meaning comes from, but is different from, a word's denotative meaning. It's very different to the denotation, to the concept. There is also the meaning that a vocabulary item has in the context or situation in which it is used. For example, in the sentence, we couldn't see the house because of the tall trees in front of it. We understand how tall the trees are. First, because we know the meaning of tall. And then, because we know how tall a house is. So the meaning of tall in this sentence is partly defined by the context. The meaning of some vocabulary items can also come from their form. For example, prefixes, suffixes, or compounds. This is nouns made from two or more separate words. Okay, we have, for example, the word bed, and we have the word room. These are two separate words. But when we put them together, bed plus room, we form or we make the word bedroom. This is a compound noun, a combination of two words that we put together to make a new meaning. Another example of a compound is
ice cream.
Ice cream. Good. You have the word ice and you have the word cream. You put them together, you make a new word with a new meaning. Or Superman. Yes, I like that one. Yes. Or headache, or pet shop, or alarm clock. Also, another example could be father-in-law, mother-in-law, stepbrother, cupcake, yes, bookstore. These are compounds, compound nouns. All right. It is important to remember the things, to revise these general concepts before we go through the heart of tonight's presentation. All right? Right now, we are going to focus on phonology. Do you teach phonology? Do you teach pronunciation in your classes? Please say yes or no. Okay, baseball. Yes, thank you, Carlos. Notebook. Robert, bookstore. Excellent, Robert. Claudia, keyboard. Thank you. Do you teach pronunciation in your classes? Sometimes, Elisa. Thanks for your honesty. You can say yes, you can say no. All right? We are not judging anyone here tonight. The thing is, we can share and we can learn together. All right, Catherine, sometimes. Would you like to learn tonight more about pronunciation so that you can teach pronunciation to your students? Eliazar.
Yes, I like it.
Important. All right, Anna, thank you. Yes, you say yes. So, do you really want to learn more about pronunciation tonight so that you can learn how to teach pronunciation to your students? Yes? Julie?
Of course.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. Thanks for answering. Okay, Lucila, you rarely teach pronunciation. All right, everyone is saying yes, yes, of course. All right, let's see what phonology is then. So phonology is the study of the sounds, features used in a language, the sounds, features used in a language to communicate meaning. In English, these features or characteristics include phonemes, word stress, sentence stress, and intonation. So these are the things that cover pronunciation. So teaching pronunciation is teaching phonemes, is teaching word stress, is teaching sentence stress, and teaching intonation. This is what we will cover, all right, so far tonight. In the platform, there are some fun videos on pronunciation, about pronunciation, from the BBC Learning website. Who has seen the videos in the platform? Please type in the chat bar. Who is saying me? Have you seen the videos I uploaded in the platform? The pronunciation videos? Yes or no? Have you watched the videos, Karim? Yes. Sarita, yes. All right. Ceci, tell me. Elisa, Claudia, Ceci Salcedo? All right, good. You said yes, yes. Okay, good. So how many symbols, so all the ones who said yes are ready to answer this question. How many phonemes, how many phonetic symbols are there in English?
44.
Excellent, 44. Cecilia, Zoila, excellent, 44. Okay, Delcy, actually we have 26 letters of the alphabet. All right, and what we will cover right now is the phonemes, the sounds we make when we speak. When we speak, we make different sounds, and each language has its own sounds. The sounds of Spanish are similar or different to the sounds of English when people speak. That's okay, Delcy. Thank you. Thanks for participating. Okay, Claudia, you are saying that you've watched the Teams pronunciation workshop videos. All right, good. The sounds are different, Edgar. Yes. And the sounds of Japanese and German, when people speak, the sounds that people make are the same or different?
They are totally different.
Very different, right? And the sounds of French are the same or different to Spanish sounds? Different, right? Yes, Cecilia, thank you. Thank you. Yes, so maybe there are some sounds that we have in many languages that we share in languages, but the majority of sounds are different. 7 or 8 years ago, I had an international teaching experience with teachers from the University of Columbia. Do you know where the University of Columbia is? Does everyone know where the University of Columbia is? Any ideas? It is in my favorite city. Yes, in the US. Yes, Edgar. Yes, Cecilia. It is in New York. The University of Columbia is in New York. And 7 or 8 years ago, I had a teaching, I was part of a teaching program, a teaching experience with teachers from the University of Columbia in New York. And there were some English teachers who were university students. They were in the foreign languages degree. They were studying the foreign languages degree, but they had a Chinese roots. So these students' parents were Chinese. So they spoke English because they were born in the United States and they were native English speakers, but they also spoke Chinese because their parents were Chinese. Some of these students were telling us that in Chinese, for one vowel, there are like sometimes more than 10 different sounds. For example, for the vowel A, they can say A, 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 A. More than 10 different sounds. Can you believe this? In English, sometimes one letter can be pronounced in more than 2 or 3 ways, the same letter. This doesn't happen in Spanish, but this does happen in English. Elisa, you're laughing because of my this is why this student was telling us that this is why it seems like Chinese are fighting when they speak. And it is not that they are fighting, but when they speak, it seems like they are fighting because they have to raise their voice and then pull it down. And it's incredible what they do with the sounds when they speak. But it is not that they are fighting. It looks like they are fighting, but they speak like that because they make the sounds when they speak. Ceci, thanks for your contribution. For 5 vowels, there are 12 sounds. All right, good. So in English, as I said before, one letter of the alphabet, one vowel, for example, can have more than 2 or 3 different pronunciations or sounds. And we are going to revise this tonight. Are you ready? The first thing we are going to revise is the vowel sounds, the easy ones. And we have here E, as in went, intent, sent, and letter, E. So I want you all to repeat after me, E, 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 went, intent, sent, letter. So there are 44 sounds we will be learning tonight. We will be revising tonight. Maybe you're familiar with this, all these sounds. And maybe you are already learning in the platform. So it is a good chance, a good opportunity tonight to revise them again, to remember this. All right? Now repeat after me. The second, cat, hand, nap, flat, half. It's like right? Okay, now repeat. Fun, laugh, money, one, London, come,
come,
fun, laugh, money, one,
mother.
All right, good. So it's not love, but what is the pronunciation?
Love.
Love. Love. All right, repeat.
Love.
Love. Man.
Look. Shoot. Cook. Book. Look. Oh. Rob. Top. Watch. Squat. Sausage. Oh. Rob, top, watch, squat, sausage. Yes. This is also called the schwa. This means, the schwa means that this sound is never stressed. It's always a weak sound.
Okay.
That word, alive, again, mother. All right, good. So we are
most of the
so far. Now the long vowels, E, R, O, U, A. All right, repeat after me. E, need, team, air, nurse, heart, third, turn. O, talk, law, board, young, yo. U, few, boot, loose, gloomy, fruit, true. Ah, fast, car, hard, bath. All right. What is a diphthong? A diphthong is a
combination of two vowels.
It's a union, a combination of two vowels. Thank you, Zoila. All right. For example, we have O plus E and we make OI. A plus E and we have I. E and U and we have O. A plus U and we have AU. Remember that these are not letters of the alphabet. These are sounds. This is not a letter U. This is the sound U. This is not a letter I, but the sound E. So O plus E is OI, as in joy, employ, toy,
oyster,
I, my, sight, bright,
kind,
light, O, stones, alone, whole, owl, mouth, house, brown, cow, out, ear. Okay, the chart I am sharing tonight has the British symbols. In American English, we say ear. Near, ear, clear. In British English, you say ear, near, clear, ear, tear, via, fear, yes, fear, right? Air, or air in American English. In American English, you say hair, there, care, stare, spare. In British English, you say hair. There, care, stairs, pair. A plus E. So this diphthong is A, as in face, space, rain, case, and eight. Okay, Julie, you want me to repeat? American, near, clear, ear, tear, beer, fear. British, near, ear, clear, tear, beer, fear. Right? You're welcome. Okay, now we're going to revise consonant sounds. These are called fricatives. Repeat after me. F, 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 f. Repeat in your homes, right there in your bedroom where you are, inside the house. Perhaps your family is getting crazy. I don't care, just practice. F, 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 f. Full. Friday.
Full.
Knife.
Fish. Knife.
Yes. Now the. Vanessa. Venezuela.
Venezuela.
Village.
Village.
Blue. Cave.
Cave. Cave.
Now. Zaragoza. Zaragoza. Zarzuela. Thought. Think. Bath.
Bath. Think.
Zaragoza, Barcelona.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Yes.
Thank you too.
Brothers.
Brothers. Others.
Good.
There. Those. Brothers. Others.
Zoo. Crazy. Lazy. Zigzag. Nose.
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 This is like the shower, the sound of the shower. When you have a shower, every second.
Yeah.
Yes.
Shirt.
Rush. Shop.
Rush.
Rush. Kayla.
Shirt.
Kayla. Shirt. Rush. Shop.
Shop. Cash.
Television.
Television.
Cash. Hi. Help. Hello. Good. Now we have what we call plosives. As in ping, cap, purpose, pause, back, bubble, build, rope, time, train, toe, late, door, day, drive, down, feet, cash, quick, cricket, sock, girl, green, grass, flag. All right, Africans, like this. Chavo, Chabela, Chela. Chosica, Chiclayo, choose, cheese, charge, watch. Right? Right, good. Now, juggle, juice, stage. Nasals now. Nasals. M-n-ng. Room. Mother. Mad. More. Now. Nobody. New. Turn. King. Thing. Song. Swimming. Right? Good. You're doing a very good job. Now we have the approximants. Road, roses, river, ring, right, road. Yellow, usual, tune, yesterday, yard, wall, walk, wine, word. Law, lots, leap, long, peel, call, chill, melt. This sound, for example, the sound la, la, doesn't exist in Japanese. Right? In Japanese, the sound la is not made. So if your name contains this letter or this sound, the sound la, they change it to ra. For example, Saul, instead of saying Saul, they say Sauro, because the sound L doesn't exist in Japanese. People don't make the sound, don't use the sound when they speak. All right. I want you to see the phonemes again. All right. You have all this info in the platform. All right. We are going to see them again to start with a game. So here are the first six. Derushi. Thank you, Delcy. What is Derushi? Your name in Japanese? Delcy, is your name Derushi? All right, Juan is Juan in Japanese. So your name Delcy, since they don't have the sound L, is Derushi. All right, thanks for telling us. All right. Here we have the first six phonemes, E, E, A, U, O, and E. Here are five more, E, R, O, U, A. Next, Oi, I, O, Au. Ia, ea, a. F, v, f, z, sh, j, h, p, p, t, d, k, g, ch, j, m, n. Ng. Right. R. G. G. L. Okay, now I want you to answer this question in the chat bar, please. Answer this question. Everyone has to answer. Here is my question. What does it say? Answer in the chat bar. Answer my question. It's time for you to practice. Yes, that's the question, Catherine. I want you to answer. Don't tell me what this is. Answer the question. Carlos-san, Carlos, Julie, good. Luzmila, good. Madeleine, good. But don't tell me the question. Tell me the answer. Excellent. Thank you. Thank you, Giovanna, Karen, Julie. Good. Yes. Because here we have ha plus how is how. You see, ha plus how is how. R and j plus u is you. How are you? Okay, good, excellent, great. Excellent, very good. Now we have one more question for you all. Excellent, thanks for answering. Roseville, Doris, Carlo, Ceci, Anna, Medali, Giovanna, Luzmila, Madeleine, Elisa, thank you, Catherine, Julie, Karen. All right, next question. Answer the question. Answer the question in the chat bar. Don't tell me what the question is, but answer the question. Excellent, Catherine, because you want to improve your teaching skills. Julie, because you want to learn more. Excellent. Excellent, Anna. That's the question. I want you to answer the question, Anna. Elisa, good. Thank you, Elisa. You want to be a better teacher. So the question here is, why are you here? Because we have gu plus I is y, r, j plus u is you, and h plus ia is here. Excellent, Doris. Excellent. So with the teachers, excellent, Cecilia. Thank you, Sarita. Excellent, Sarita, Doris, Silvia, good. Ana, good. Carlos, thank you. Claudia, Roseville, Giovanna, Lucila, and Delcy. Excellent, all right. All right. Okay. Good, Medali, because you want to learn more. All right. All right, that's fantastic. So we, the teachers, have to be familiar with these phonemes, with these symbols. We should know this because we are the teachers. At the very beginning of tonight's presentation, I asked you how good are you at the different systems, at the three systems. And I told you that if your answer is so-so, my grammar is not very well, or my pronunciation or my vocabulary, you have to take action, all right? You have to take action. All right? Cecilia Salcedo, Robert, you are raising your hand. Yes, you can please turn on your microphone. All right, look, Robert, no, okay. Yes, it's time to take action, Claudia. We have to know these things. Some teachers say, I don't really need to learn advanced grammar because I teach in primary. Is this good? Do you think this is okay? It's okay, Robert. That's okay, thank you. I'm going to say this again. Some teachers say, I don't really need to have an advanced grammar because I only teach in primary. Do you think this is okay? Delcy says no. Thank you, Delcy. What do you say? Is this okay? Okay. Elisa, no. Anna, no. Robert, no. Edgar, no. Excellent, no. The answer is no, because we are the teachers, and no matter what level we teach, we have to know the language very well, because we are the teachers. Right? Excellent, Catherine. In any level, we have to be prepared. Elisa, the more a teacher knows, the more efficient he or she will be in his or her teaching. Yes. Natural way, Anna. So it is not that we have to prepare or we have to study or we have to learn according to the level we will teach. No. We have to have advanced grammar, advanced vocabulary, advanced pronunciation, just simply because we are the teachers. And as I said at the beginning, we have to be good at both languages, our own languages and the language we teach. This is English. So we have to be good at the Spanish grammar. We have to be good at the Spanish pronunciation. We have to be good at Spanish vocabulary. Sometimes teachers are asked to speak in public and they don't even know how to start, how to greet people, how to introduce themselves. And this shouldn't be like this because we are the teachers. We are professionals. We have to be prepared. Claudia says that it depends on what we expect from ourselves. Yes, it's true, but we should be expecting the best for us and from us. Robert, yes, as I said, we have to be prepared. If we don't do, nobody's going to do for us. Yes, that's true. Julie, you agree with me? Thank you. So no matter what level you teach, you have to be good at grammar, pronunciation and vocabulary because you are the teacher. All right, so I have to be good at grammar, pronunciation, and vocabulary. Why? Because I am the teacher. All right? Let's move on to the next slide then, which is a revision of the three systems, grammar, vocabulary, and pronunciation. We have some questions. I want you to participate in the chat bar or just turn on your microphone and give me the answer. How much do you know about each language system? What language system is this? Tenses, such as the present continuous, the past simple, the past perfect, simple, the future going to, and the future will, are connected to what system? A, B, or C? Please give me your answer. You can turn on your microphone or you can
type grammar.
This is
connected. It's related to grammar.
Yes, A, grammar, grammar. Yes, the answer is grammar. Okay, are you familiar with this? Do you know the rules, how you form the present simple, the present continuous, the past perfect simple, when you use the future going to, and when you use the future will? Are you familiar with this? Elisa says yes, Claudia, yes, excellent, congratulations. Some other grammatical forms you have to be familiar with are first conditional, zero conditional, second conditional, third conditional, modals. And we have to know this, the rules, when we use them, etc., how to use them, because we are the teachers. And as I said before, we cannot assume that we don't really need to have an advanced grammar because we only teach kinder or primary. Yes, Karin, present perfect, passive voice. Yes, excellent, Robert. These things are related to grammar. Okay, second question. Producing sounds such as a in dan and j in yellow is connected to what? Your answer?
Pronunciation.
Pronunciation. Yes, Julie, yes. Claudia, Madeleine, pronunciation. Good.
Pronunciation, right.
You're right. Okay. Next. Talking about opposites, for example, new versus old, is connected to
letters B, sir, vocabulary.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Robert. Vocabulary, right? This means we have to know about synonyms, antonyms, homophones. We have to be familiar with these things. Why? Because we are the teachers, remember. Simple as that. Talking about which words are said more loudly and more strongly in a sentence. For example, I finished last night versus I finished last night is connected to what?
Letter C, sir, pronunciation.
Pronunciation. Yes, sir. Pronunciation. Pronunciation. Because sometimes when we want to emphasize something we are saying, we raise the volume of our voice. And this has to do with intonation. And intonation is one feature of pronunciation, one of the features of pronunciation. For example, when we ask a question, there is a different intonation, right? If you say, your house is in London, your house is in Motupe, And if I ask a question, I say, is your house in Motupe? There's a different intonation, right? And this also happens in our language, in Spanish. This has to do with pronunciation. Intonation then is a feature of pronunciation. Emphasis, yes, Claudia, falling and rising. Okay, knowing how to order words in a sentence, for example, Arequipa is also called the white city, not Arequipa is also called the city white, is connected to what? Grammar? Vocabulary? Or pronunciation? In the chat bar, you're saying grammar? Yes. Yes.
Grammar.
This has to do with the position of adjectives in a sentence. In English, for example, adjective, you have an adjective and a noun, the adjective always goes first. But in Spanish, it is the opposite. In Spanish, you say, Arequipa is a city white. But in English, you say, the white city. And this has to do with adjectives. Word order, yes. Thank you, Claudia. Knowing that we make decisions, not take decisions, is connected to what? We do homework, we don't make homework.
Grammar.
You do homework. This is connected to? Some of you are saying grammar, some others are saying vocabulary. So what would be the
vocabulary
answer?
Vocabulary too.
Vocabulary. So with collocations, some words collocate with other words in English. Some words combine with other words in English. Some words just don't combine or don't collocate. For example, you say, I do homework or I make homework.
I do homework.
You do exercise or you make exercise?
Make exercise.
Make exercise.
You make exercise?
Do exercise. Do
exercise. Do exercise. Do exercise.
Yes. So homework and make don't collocate, don't combine. Homework collocates, homework combines with do. These are called collocations, and this has to do with vocabulary. We have to know this. Why? Because we are the teachers. Yeah, do plus activities, physical, especially. Claudia, thank you. Yes, thanks for participating. Claudia, Carlos, Elisa, have and take. Also, Edgar, thank you. Number 7, deciding whether your voice should go up or down at the end of a sentence. What Claudia said, rising, falling, is connected to what? To? Yes, yes, Elisa, thank you. To pronunciation. To pronunciation. We should know this. Number 8, understanding the difference between I used to have lunch in my office and I'm used to having lunch in my office is connected to. Connected to what?
Grammar. Grammar.
Grammar? You all are saying grammar?
Yes.
Yes, grammar. Yes.
Grammar. Grammar. Grammar, right? So if you say, I used to have lunch in my office, has the same meaning as I'm used to having lunch in my office? Is this the same meaning?
I'm used to having lunch.
No, it's not the same meaning. Yes, Julie, no. So used to is different to be used to. So one is used to when you talk about things you did in the past, but you no longer do in the present. You don't do this.
Solía.
Right? Yes, you say, for example, in the past, I used to smoke. I used to smoke in the past. Does this mean that I smoke now? Do I smoke now?
No.
No. I stopped smoking. I used to. But be used to. So I used to have lunch in my office. Now I don't have lunch in the office. I have lunch at home or in a restaurant. And to be used to is to be accustomed to, yes, as you are saying in the chat box. Julie, thank you. Thanks for your interventions. Thank you, Doris. Thank you, Claudia. Thank you, Julie. Thanks, Karin, Melendez, all right? So to be used to is to be accustomed to do something. So I am used to sleeping with the TV on, for example, all right? So these are two totally different things, and we have to know the things, all right? Because we are supposed to cover some of this in our teaching. All right, one more. Knowing that saying someone is slim pays a compliment. So slim is a positive adjective. If I say that you are slim, this is good because slim means a thin and attractive. But if I say that you are skinny, this is a criticism. This is not well seen. So this is connected to what? Vocabulary. Yes, excellent, excellent. You all are answering correctly in the chat box. For example, the word ugly is a very strong and impolite word. If you say, for example, my first sister is beautiful, but my second sister is ugly, ugly is a very offensive word. It's a criticism. All right? Or you say, my ex-girlfriend was very ugly. Or you say that your ex-boyfriend was ugly. So ugly is not a polite word. It is not a correct word. A better word would be unattractive, which is the opposite of attractive. So you say, my first sister is beautiful. The second one is unattractive or is not very attractive. But she is so cool. All right? All right. So what do teachers need to know about grammar? What do we, the teachers, need to know about grammar? Well, grammar refers to how we combine, organize and change parts of words and groups of words to make meaning. We saw this in one of the previous slides. Also, I mentioned that we use grammar unconsciously when we speak, listen, read, and write, and we also use it particularly as teachers to describe language. And we do this by referring to its forms and its uses, and grammar includes a large number of forms and uses, such as present continuous, present simple, past perfect simple, past perfect continuous, etc. Grammar is about how we construct words and use words together to make phrases and sentences which allow us to convey what we mean and communicate with other people. So the first thing teachers need to know about grammar is the different types of words we use to construct sentences. These are called parts of speech. There are 9 parts of speech in English: nouns, verbs, adjectives, adverbs, determiners, prepositions, pronouns, conjunctions, and exclamations. A part of a speech or word class describes how words behave in sentences. This is how they operate and combine grammatically with other words. Here are the 9 parts of a speech and an example for each of them. A noun, for example, is a word which names people or things. For example, Tom, desk, hope. Tom is a proper noun. Desk is a noun too, but it is different from the word Tom, because Tom is proper because it is the name of a person, and desk is common. Hope is also a common noun, but it is in the category of abstract nouns. it is abstract because we cannot measure this noun. We cannot see or touch this noun. In the first section of the platform, we have a video about abstract nouns. Have you seen the video in the platform, dear trainees? The video about abstract nouns in the platform? Yes, all right, Elsie, good. Good, Doris. So we have also pronouns, verbs, adverbs, adjectives, prepositions. Thank you, Ceci, Karim, good. Prepositions, conjunctions, determiners, interjections. We have to be familiar with these 9 parts of a speech. Now we are going to have an activity, a task, an exercise to increase our knowledge of parts of a speech. So the different types of words are called parts of a speech or word classes. I am sure that you are familiar with some of these parts of a speech, but do you know them all? Right? Let's see these examples. Okay, we have the first 5. There are 9 in total. We have 5 only here. Now, which of the of those would be examples of nouns? In which line do we see examples of nouns? Yes, table, the line that says table. Yes, Julie, thank you. Table, Spanish, honesty, love, and Ica are examples of nouns. Table is a common noun, Spanish is a proper noun, honesty is common also, but abstract, love is also abstract and common. Ica is a proper noun, it's the name of a city in the south of Peru, where you can eat delicious sopa seca and carapulcra. Actually, that's my favorite dish, if you didn't know. So on my birthday, you can go to Ica and buy a plate of carapulcra and sopa seca and then give it to me as a present, all right? What would be examples of pronouns? Yeah, Elisa, good idea. So that you travel.
I mean, yes, you, she, who.
Yes.
The first one.
Yes. So here we have relative pronouns like who. We have personal pronouns or subject pronouns like I and she and you. We have object pronouns like me and us. Okay, what would be the group of verbs?
Yeah, well,
yes, come across, do, eat, and practice. Yeah. Right, good. Adverb. Now, beautifully, always, slowly. Now is an adverb of time. Beautifully is an adverb of manner. Always is an adverb of frequency. Slowly is also an adverb of manner.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Okay, and in the group of adjectives, we have his, which is a possessive adjective, the best, which is a superlative adjective, dark, a 0-degree adjective, 0-degree or like normal adjective, and happier, which is a comparative adjective. Great, you've done a very good job. We have 4 more now. All right, which would be the group of prepositions?
Toward, on, by, and it.
Excellent. Toward, on, by, at, and in. Conjunctions.
Such,
so, or because, and.
Excellent. Determiner.
Good, or hey.
Some.
Up, down.
Yes. Yes. A determiner is a
some
word.
AD. My.
It's a word that helps you identify a specific thing. Examples of determiners are numbers, articles, and quantifiers. And interjections, examples of interjections are
good, good, good. Oh.
Hey, wow. All right, now here's what I promised to share tonight. ELT games and ideas for teaching the three language systems. There are many resources available for teaching the three systems of the language. There are many resources. Now we are going to try to cover them all or focus on most of them so that you have an opportunity to enrich your teaching. All right? One resource we have for teaching grammar and for teaching vocabulary and for teaching pronunciation is the board. Yes, what a nice group, Claudia. You're right. The board is a great, a fantastic resource. Do you use the board in your classes? In face-to-face classes, do you use the board? Or it's only part of the decoration of your classroom?
Yes. Nowadays, I used to use in the past.
But you have a board also in online teaching. In your online teaching, do you use the board?
Yes.
There is a board, there is a screen. Do you use it?
Yes, that's right.
Yes, right? So we use the board to present the language through explanations, sometimes through drawings and examples to clarify, to consolidate language. Another resource is realia or real objects. For example, a bag of fruit, oranges, apples, bananas, pears, grapes. If you are teaching classroom items, you show the students real items like they play with their pens, their sharpeners, shells, staplers. Right, especially when teaching vocabulary, right? We can use realia. If you are teaching clothes, you can ask the students to bring clothes and to, because in schools, students, all students have to wear a uniform, right? So you can tell the students to bring their favorite clothes to school. To change their clothes at break time so that when you start the classes, they all are wearing their favorite clothes. And then they start to speak and to share and to tell everyone the clothes they are wearing. That's a great idea. An example on how we use realia or real objects. Also, another resource. Yes, Julie, it's great. I've done that and it's fantastic. The students love it. All right, so you have to tell to your coordinator or to the principal about this idea that since you know that the students have to wear a uniform, you want them to bring their clothes to the school and at break time, they will change clothes so that they share the clothes they are wearing. Yes, even university students. Another great resource is worksheets. And we use worksheets to revise, also to consolidate, to present language. We also have published materials. This is course books, electronic books, supplementary materials such as DVDs, CD-ROMs. We use this to teach grammar, to teach vocabulary, to teach pronunciation. Sorry, it is a mistake here, a typing mistake here. Let me fix this right now. It is authentic materials here, authentic. Can you see the correction I am making right now? All right, good. You see, this means we are having a live event right now. Okay, authentic materials, such as newspapers, magazines, leaflets, brochures, menu cards, songs, YouTube videos. These are fantastic resources for teaching grammar, for teaching vocabulary, for teaching pronunciation. And the most important of all, the resources. What is the most important resource? The best resource. This is better than worksheets, better than videos, better than the book. What is the most important resource?
Our knowledge.
Yes, excellent, Zoila, excellent, Julie, excellent, Anna. The most important is you. The most important resource is you, the teacher. Okay, it is not the book nor the technology. You can just know you are the most important resource because you have the power to motivate or demotivate the students. You can make a class fun. With a TV, without a TV, with a projector, without a projector. Everything is in your hands. So we, the teachers, are the most important resource. There are also many resources available on the internet for teaching the three systems of the language, for teaching grammar, vocabulary, and pronunciation, such as digital resources. This is resources available online. With online games, we have the Cambridge English website, with materials for exam and non-exam classes, lesson plans, visual aids, texts, YouTube clips, teachers apps, learners apps, mobile phones. And we also have digital tools. This is resources for teachers. Like the English vocabulary profile, the English grammar profile, the text inspector. We are going to see this later on. If there's time tonight, if not, in our next webinar, which will be again about how to teach the three systems of the language effectively. All right, before we explore the resources, I want to share these top tips for how to select resources, okay? Here are some tips on selecting or making your own resources. First, make sure that the resource will help you achieve your lesson aim, that the resource you will use is connected to the goals, the objectives of your lesson. Also, make sure that the resource is appropriate for the group of students, that the topic in the resource is relevant and interesting for your students. Also make sure that the students like doing the kind of activity that the resource asks them to do. Make sure that you haven't done too much of this kind of activity recently. Make sure that the resource helps you to provide variety in the lesson. Make sure that you are allowed to photocopy or otherwise distribute this resource. No copyright. And make sure that the resource doesn't take you a long time to prepare. And last but not least, you can use the activity, make sure that you can use the activity again with another class. All right, I have taken this information in the last two slides from the futurelearn.com website, in which you can find lots of teaching courses. All right, do you know this resource? Can you see my screen? Do you know the Sing and Learn? Yes, Julie, good. Okay, Delcy, yes. No, Julie? Okay, here at the Sing and Learn, you find song with the lyrics and stories and reading comprehension for children. Giovanna, good. Do you know this one, the One Stop English?
No.
One Stop English, yes, no? Julie, yes? There are lots of resources for teaching the three systems. Elisa, no? All right, for teaching grammar, vocabulary, pronunciation. The ESL Games, have you ever been there? At the ESL Games website? Yes? Fun, right? It is so fun. Doris, yes. Monkey puzzles, have you ever made your students play with the monkey puzzles? It's for teaching vocabulary. Also, you learn grammar here. There is pronunciation here for children. Education.com. Here you can create your own worksheets, you can create puzzles, crosswords, Word of Fun. This is another Cambridge website, which is exam oriented. Starters, movers, and flyers. All right, so it's good that you see this tonight and you learn something new. Okay, I will be sharing this with you. You can take a screenshot, you can take a photo right now if you want, but I will share this presentation with you again so that you can access these links and know in detail what you can find inside these resources. Sing and Learn, One Stop English, ESL Games Word, Monkey Puzzles, education.com, and Word of Fun. All right. Okay, now here's a video. A video because we are talking about games and ideas for teaching grammar. Here is a story for teaching grammar. Last week, I told you that when you teach children, you shouldn't focus on grammar because grammar is too abstract for little children. They don't really understand grammar. So teaching grammar would be a waste of time. But this doesn't mean that we don't present grammar in our classes. How do we present grammar when teaching children? Through stories, through songs, through games. Here is a story for presenting grammar to children. The story is called Grammar with Gram. Okay, I'm going to click on this icon so that you can watch this video. Right, so here's a way we can present grammar to children. After you make the children watch the video, you work on an activity for reinforcing vocabulary, for reinforcing grammar, for revising vocabulary, for revising grammar, for consolidating vocabulary, for consolidating grammar. All right. Where did I get this? Where did I find this? All right. I'm going to share a new screen right now. Okay, just give me a second. All right, can you see my screen? Can you see the new screen? Yes? All right, good. Yes.
Yes.
This is the learnenglishkids.britishcouncil.org website. You know, the British Council is an international institution that is investing a lot of time and a lot of money in English teaching. So the British Council is helping teachers all over the world to do their job, successfully, to teach English effectively. There is a website, a British Council website for teachers of kids or teachers of children, which is the one you are seeing here. There is another for teaching teenagers, another for teaching adults, and another for teachers, with teaching resources, teaching materials, etc. Here, at this website, there are different sections like listen and watch. Can you see my screen now? Here you have songs, short stories, poems, the video song, the how-to videos. You have reading and writing, speaking, spelling, grammar and vocabulary, fun and games, print and make. And the best thing is that everything is for free. Here you have the video, for example, we've just watched, Kitty's Dream Job. And also, you can download the activities, the worksheets for the activities for the video. You can download these materials for free. If you click here, print an activity for the video, a new window will open, and you will be able to download the worksheet. Also, you can, there is an option here that says print the answers. You can also print the answers with the answers of the activity. What do you think of this? Do you like it? Can you see my screen? All right, good. As you can see, there are different sections here, not only grammar, but there is also speaking, listening, reading, writing. There are games. We are going to try one of the games tonight. This is the Animal Band quiz. So right now we are sharing ideas and games for teaching grammar, vocabulary, and pronunciation. All right, right now the focus is on games and ideas for teaching children. We will see games and ideas for teaching teenagers later on, if there's time tonight, if not in the next webinar. All right, so we have a game here, which is about music. How much do you know about music? Try this quiz and find out how much do you know. Okay, who can help me? The most popular musical instrument in the world is the drums, the guitar, or the violin?
The guitar.
The guitar. Correct. Musicians can read and write musical notes, musical signs, or musical words. Musical notes. Yes, correct. Elisa, good. Musical instruments vibrate to make. Vibrate to make.
Sounds. Sounds.
Good. Good. All right. So as you can see, there are games also. There is one section here that is called the story maker. Here you can make, you can create your own story. For example, here. All right, can you see the screen now? Can you see my screen? It is still loading. Can you see the screen?
Yes, teacher.
All right, sorry. Okay, which type of a story are we going to choose tonight? Do you want to create right now a fairy story, science fiction, or horror?
Fairy story, please.
Horror? Horror or fairy? What did you say?
Fairy.
Fairy, okay.
Fairy.
Okay, okay. This story is about a king and a queen. Okay, choose where they live. Where do they live? Choose.
Castle.
Castle.
Okay. Thank you. Castle. The king and queen have a daughter. What's her name? Choose a name for the daughter of the king and the queen.
Alexia.
Alexia.
Alexia, okay. What's the best prize to get?
A ring.
A ring, okay, a ring. Someone marked this, but I heard a ring. This is why I'm choosing a ring. Okay, what's your favorite musical instrument?
Piano.
Piano, all right. There is a boy in this story. What's his job, the job of the boy in the story? Farmer, all right. The boy in the story has got a pet. What pet is it? What pet? Parrot. Okay, parrot. I heard parrot. Okay, here is our story. Once upon a time, there was a king and a queen. They lived in a lovely golden castle and had a beautiful daughter, Alexia. But Alexia was very unhappy. She never loved or smiled. We will give a ring to the person who can make Alexia happy, said the queen. A musician came and played the piano. A fairy said a magic spell and a joker came and told jokes. But Alexia did not smile or laugh. A young farmer came to work at the queen's castle. He came with his little parrot. The little parrot liked to play. One day, Alexia saw the parrot and started to smile. Then she laughed. The queen heard her daughter and saw the parrot. The parrot was happy to get a ring. The end. Did you like it?
Yes, I did.
Claudia, sí, chévere. Yes, chévere, Claudia, yes. So what grammar were we revising here? What tense were we teaching or revising here?
Past simple.
Past simple, right? Past simple, good. All right, now we are going to have a look at another website, which is the gamestolearnenglish.com. All right, we are going to choose a level here. Easy. Okay, let's start. This one is, tell me.
Police officer.
A police officer.
Please.
Firefighter.
Hairdresser. Yes. Teacher.
Okay, she is or he is? Look at the photo. Look at the picture.
He is.
He is. Look at the shadow. Look at the photo. Oh,
teacher.
A teacher.
He's a teacher.
You are very slow tonight. A teacher. A teacher. Continue the sentence.
Teaches.
A teacher teaches.
Teachers.
The students.
Excellent.
He's
a chef, sir. He's a chef.
A chef cooks food. A chef cooks food. Yes.
She's a firefighter.
A police officer arrests criminals. He's a farmer.
A doctor helps sick people.
He's a hairdresser.
Cuts hair.
All right. Did you like
there are it? Nurse, yes.
Athlete.
Businessman. Yeah. Lawyer.
Waiter.
Cashier.
Research.
He's a waiter. We are teachers.
We are going to stop here, all right? Good. Okay. And I'm going to present my PowerPoint again. All right. All right, great. All right. Can you see my presentation again?
Yes.
All right. So, as I said before, the British Council is investing a lot of money in English teaching. And there is again a website for children, one for teenagers, one for adults, and one for teachers. Here are the links of the websites we've just explored. The jobs game here is the one we played about jobs right now. The one we were playing a few seconds ago. The Animal Band Quiz is the game about music. The Story Maker is the story of Alexia. All right? Here is a link to the British Council website for teenagers. Here is the link. And some practical ideas for teaching grammar to teenagers, which includes worksheets, videos, etc. All right, as I said, in our next webinar, we are going to continue covering this topic, which is the three language systems. There isn't more time right now. I will share this. I just want to revise this terminology. The terminology we learned today, a compound noun, which is a combination of two or more words, which are used as a single word, for example, flower shop, headache, you said ice cream, etc. Elisa, yes, we will share materials for teenagers and adults in our next webinar. We haven't finished with this topic tonight. This is the first part. All right, we have part two in 3 more weeks because we are going to stop for 2 weeks and then we will have the next webinar in August. Another word we learned today is a diphthong. This is a vowel combination. You're welcome, Claudia. And yes, great, Elisa. A diphthong then is the union of two vowels, usually involving a quick but smooth movement from one vowel to another. For example, I as in my. A feature is an interesting or important part or characteristic of something. And this is, we use this word to refer pronunciation tonight. You are welcome, Karin. Anna, if you want to participate in the next webinar, you can send me an email to jvalenzuela@abilitiesandeducation.com and I will tell you how, all right? You're welcome, Anna. Okay, you're welcome, Giovanna. Another word we learned tonight, which is related to teaching terminology, is consolidate. This is to return to something, to understand and remember it more completely. For example, students can consolidate grammar points by doing extra practice. Variety is another word we learned tonight. This is to introduce different things, such as different types of activities or tasks, language skills, interaction patterns, pacing or timing into a lesson. Good teachers try to include variety in their lesson so that the students stay interested. Leaflet, brochure, this is a piece of printed paper that gives information or advertises something. This is one example of realia. And supplementary material, the books and other materials which teachers can use in addition to a course book. For example, pronunciation practice materials. Okay, I will type the email here. Please, Anna, be attentive. I will type the email here. Okay, Anna, did you receive it? J. Valenzuela. Anna, can you see my email address? jvalenzuela@abilitiesandeducation.com. Okay, now I want everyone to write in the chat bar one or two things you learned tonight. Okay, Anna. Very good. Thanks also for your interest. Write in the chat box one thing you learned tonight, one thing you discovered tonight. Please. You're welcome, Lucila. Pronunciation, Julie. Great. Pronunciation is fun. You learned that tonight. Please, I want you all to say something. What did you learn tonight? Share in the chat bar, in the chat box. Don't think too much, just tell me, what did you learn tonight?
Este,
Sir, good morning. We learned about the language systems.
Uh-huh.
About pronunciation, grammar, and vocabulary, sir.
Okay, thank you, Roberto. Elisa, thank you. How to teach the systems in an efficient, in an effective way. All right, web pages to create a story, games to practice grammar, Madeleine, Claudia. Grammar is a key, good, Elita. Grammar, Giovanna, grammar, vocabulary, and pronunciation. Okay, good. Language systems. Gracie, Lisette, good, grammar, Doris, pronunciation, good. Catherine, different tools. Usmila, grammar, new games, excellent.
Grammar.
Here, on this link, you can access a free webinar, a webinar I deliver this year in April. When the quarantine started, Editorial Norma offered a webinar, a free webinar for teachers. And the recording, you can access the recording of this webinar, which is some extra information on how to teach the three language systems through this link. If you click here, you can access another webinar delivered by me on language systems. It was so interesting. I delivered this webinar this year in April. If you click here on this link, you can access this webinar. Okay? Maria Isabel, systems, resources, website. Okay, Gracie, you're welcome. Thank you too. Thank you all. Thank you all. All right. Okay, good. Good, very good. So that's
thank
the
you.
End of, that's the end of today's webinar. You're welcome. Thank you all. Thank you all for being here. Yes, see you next webinar.
See you next.
Too.
See you, take care.
See you. Bye-bye. 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 Take care. Goodbye. Bye-bye. Please. Bye.
Goodbye, teacher. Thank you.
The photo. Turn on your cameras. Don't leave the room yet. Turn on your cameras.
Okay, sir, thank you very much. Have a great week. Thank you.
You too, sir. Photo, all right. All right.
Bye-bye,
take care.
Bye-bye, take care.
Goodbye. Bye, teacher.
Bye-bye, take care.
Goodbye, teacher. Bye, teacher Juan Jose.
Bye-bye.
Bye, teacher Juan Jose.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye for everybody.
Mm-hmm. Bye. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Okay. See you the next week.
Yes. Bye-bye. Take care. See you.
Take care, teacher, too.